We want to celebrate the release of Crash Bandicoot 4 by creating a WebAR video game in Unity. We also present to you ARWT, a library we have developed and just released for free on our GitHub page. Our goal is to create a bridge between Unity and the best AR libraries available for WebAR. Creating a 3D scene and game in a graphic engine like Unity is 100 times more convenient than making it in a different environment. At the moment, we support market tracking and we are currently working on environmental understanding. We invite you to download our library and test it. Of course, since it's a side project for us, it still has many problems that require study and fixes, but what we have achieved so far is very encouraging. Please go and check our website to learn more about it, the roadmap, the documentation, and how to support us. First thing first, we download some 3D assets from these awesome creators. We need Crash, Wumpa Fruit, TNT, and another generic obstacle. To animate Crash, we need a skeleton and bones, so we open Blender and we start to rig our character. We try to use Mixamo, but this big nose doesn't help the auto-rigging tool get a good result. Hello, darkness, my old friend. Now the most relaxing and maybe long part of the project, animating. We create a run animation, a jump animation, and an idle animation. Now that we have our assets, it's time to think of a video game suitable for an AR marker experience. We want a game that lives on a marker, so it has a little space to take place. We ended to create an endless runner. So we start to develop the basic logic behind the game object's movement. We put a running Crash Bandicoot at the center of the plane and, by moving the texture of the plane and the objects, we achieve the impression of the character movement. Since we are working on the web, we need to optimize everything. So, instead of instantiating a new game object each time we need it, we use object pooling and queues to recycle and reuse elements. In other words, instead of destroying an object, you deactivate it and insert it again in a queue that contains all the elements of the same type ready to be used. We deactivate an active object when it reaches the end of the level or when it has an interaction with Crash Bandicoot. Talking about interactions, of course we want to collect Wumpa Fruits. Each time we take one of them, we increase the difficulty of the game by a percentage. A game synchronizer script handles all the speeds and increases by the right amount each element. Touching TNT is not a good idea, so if you collide with it, you die. We downloaded the Crash Angel model to replicate the die effect of the original video game. We also use it with the trunk collision, and we add the two particles to them. Another essential optimization for the web is avoiding to instantiate particles at runtime. So we place the particles right in the point of the impact and we play them when the collision occurs. Showing the entire level at full dimension in IR marker experience is wrong. So we develop a shader that renders only the objects that are inside a specific area. As you can see, we can define an area thanks to a script and everything outside is not rendered. These features makes the game more challenging since you don't know what's next. To receive the user input and control the character, we create a player controller script. Here we have some simple logics that handle the actions of Crash Bandicoot, like switching from running to jump, prevent to jump when you are already jumping, reset the character when you die, etc. In the end, we add UI elements as a last tribute to the original game. When Crash gathers an apple, we move the apple toward the UI apple icon. We build the game upload the content on our website, and this is the final result. The link is public, so you can play and test it on your device. You can find the link in the description and also a link to the marker. You can try to frame it from the computer screen, but it will not be very stable because each monitor changes a little the marker's colors. The game is also designed to be played on a horizontal plane and not on a vertical screen. Let us know your score in the comments below and if you liked our video. Please test our library, it's at an early stage and we need support and feedbacks. If you work with it, you can also propose your changes, fixes on GitHub, and we will be happy to check them and integrate them. Follow us for more, subscribe and smash the like button. Thanks and see you in the next video. Bye!